Geriatric Psychology, Wikipedia Audio. Geriatric psychology is a subfield of psychology that specializes in the mental and physical health of those in the later stage of life. These specialized psychologists study a variety of psychological abilities that deplete as aging occurs, such as memory, learning capabilities, and coordination. Geriatric psychologists work with elderly clients to conduct the diagnosis, study, and treatment of certain mental illnesses in a variety of workplace settings. Geriatric psychology requires many years of schooling, including a PhD program, an internship, and postdoctoral fellowships. A geriatric psychologist specializes in the treatment of the elderly. This treatment can include mental health problems or aid in the understanding and coping with the aging process. In order to become a geriatric psychologist, one must obtain a doctoral degree in psychology and specialize in adult development and aging. Once the degree is obtained, geriatric psychologists will usually work in hospitals, mental health clinics, rehab centers, nursing homes, and research centers. Most geriatric psychologists work in medical facilities, however. Geriatric psychologists spend most of their work day addressing mental health issues in older adults and counseling those that need it. They also aid in the diagnosis of age-related problems. In order to check for mental health issues, geriatric psychologists will conduct clinical interviews, neuropsychological tests, and behavioral observations. Geriatric psychology is based upon the study of mental functions with aging. The psychologist's purpose is to observe how the neurological and physiological process of an elderly adult's brain affects their behaviors in daily life. When a psychologist is specialized in geriatrics, they provide care for declining brain functions to make life better. Geriatric psychiatry is more about the diagnosis and treatment of certain mental disorders, such as the ones listed below. A geriatric psychiatrist is also a licensed doctor that can prescribe medications for elderly patients. Psychiatrists require an education and degree from a medical school. Role of the geriatric psychologist. Geriatric psychology began in 1978 with a spike in interest in mental health and the effects of aging. There was a slow increase in the number of aging adults in the U.S. population. There was a small group of 11 people who met together to talk about late-life mental health needs and the field of geriatrics. This meeting later created the American Association of Geriatric Psychology. As time has gone on, the small group has turned into a very large group of people dedicated to the well-being of the aging population. It is important to study the phenomenon of loneliness in the aging community, as many older individuals face a variety of problems, including physical illness, when faced with this common problem. It is important for nurses and other individuals who work in association with the elderly to understand the various theories of loneliness, as they may need to implement these perspectives into enhancing the lives of their patients. Depression in the elderly community can have severe consequences, which is why it is an important public health problem and research area. Older adults facing this debilitating condition are less likely to endorse affective symptoms and are more likely to instead display cognitive changes, somatic symptoms, and loss of interest than are younger adults. It is comorbid with morbidity, increased risk of suicide, decreased physical, cognitive, and social functioning, and greater self-neglect, all of which are associated with an increase in mortality. Dementia is a variety of symptoms that apply to a decline in mental ability, not a specific disease. Geriatric psychologists work with dementia by aiding in the diagnosis of this disease. This is done through various cognitive tests and assessments. They will also look at research and potential treatment for dementia. Alzheimer's disease is the most common type of dementia, accounting for 60 to 80% of dementia cases. Similar to dementia, a geriatric psychologist's role regarding Alzheimer's disease is the assessment, treatment, and research of the disease. Vascular dementia, the second most common type of dementia, is the result of a stroke. A geriatric psychologist aids in the assessment, diagnosing, treatment, and research of vascular dementia. Parkinson's disease is a movement disorder that has symptoms like tremors, slowing down, stiffness, and impaired balance. A geriatric psychologist's role for those with Parkinson's disease would be helping the person diagnosed deal with the stress they may encounter regarding Parkinson's disease. Since it is not a brain disorder, the geriatric psychologist would not help with diagnosing or the treatment of the disease. Psychology versus psychiatry. History. Research areas. Loneliness in elderly people. Depression. Dementia. Alzheimer's disease. Vascular dementia. Parkinson's disease.